Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. We've learned several ways to communicate chemical structure, and now we're going to learn a new method, Lineangle notation, Lineangle structures, sometimes called skeletal structures. Okay, on the screen we have our rules for Lineangle notation. Rule number one is we don't label our carbon atoms. We can assume if an atom is unlabeled that it's a carbon atom. Rule number two, hydrogen atoms on carbon atoms are not labeled. So carbon is so predictable in having four bonds that we're going to assume if we seem to be missing bonds on carbon, those missing bonds must be bonds to unshown hydrogen atoms. And then rule number three, lone pair electrons are not shown. Since our atoms are going to be very predictable in terms of satisfying the octet rule, we're going to assume that we have enough lone pair electrons on atoms to fill up the octet if they don't satisfy the octet rule. Let's see a real example. So on the screen to the bottom left, we have isopropanol. Isopropanol has three carbon atoms, and this is what this molecule looks like as a Lineangle structure. That's it. Lineangle notation is much, much more compact than the Lewis dot structure method. And that's why people flock to it so much. So let's number our carbon atoms. This is actually carbon number one right here. And the next line is ends at carbon number two, and carbon number three is there. So let's look at carbon number one. I'm going to put kind of a big dot there. That's our carbon. That we have one bond shown in that molecule, carbon one to carbon two. That's one bond. Well, carbon makes four bonds. So the missing bonds must be to hydrogens. And sure enough, over on the left on the Lewis structure, we can see it had three hydrogens. Carbon two, we can think of much the same way. Carbon two has three bonds shown. It should have four. Therefore, the extra bond must be a missing hydrogen. And that is indeed has a CH. Carbon three is much like carbon one. And then finally, we have the oxygen. So off of carbon 2, we have a bond to oxygen. And we don't have to show the lone pairs. We know that oxygen, as drawn in the structure, has two bonds. One to carbon 2, one to a hydrogen. And note that we must show that hydrogen. That's an OH, not a CH. CHs are optional. OHs are not optional. We must show that hydrogen. So the oxygen has two bonds. If it has two bonds, it only has four valence electrons. We know it satisfies the octet rule with eight, so it needs to have two lone pairs. I'm going to draw them in, but you don't have to draw them. So that's our full Lineangle structure. So let's now look over to the right and see some other features. So this molecule is just propane. How would we draw propane? Well, you might say, well, I have three carbons in a row. One, two, three. And that's a reasonable thing to assume based on the rules on the screen. However, because this is just a line, from reading it, it'd be easy to say, oh, that's just a line. That's a carbon on the end. That label's not shown. And that's a carbon on the end. It's very hard to know that what you intended was a carbon right in the middle. So how does Lineangle notation address this? Well, this is why we tend to see zigzags in our structure. This then becomes clear. Here is a line. This line is a bond. And the end of the lines, if they're unlabeled, must be a carbon atom. So the end of this line, that's a carbon atom. That's carbon 2 of propane, and then carbon 3 of propane. Let's just number our propane carbons on our Lewis structure. So this is why when you see these structures drawn in Lineangle notation, you see these zigzags. That's the angle in Lineangle notation. And that way you know atom there, 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 there. So this would be the Lineangle notation structure for hexane. Lineangle notation, it's quick, it's easy. Once you learn to read them, I think they're fairly intuitive. They also kind of have a beauty to them. So you'll see advertising on television and in the print media where people will want to portray science. And what do they often do? They'll go to these Lineangle structures because they're pretty and they kind of have this neat look. So it's kind of an aesthetic quality of organic chemistry. But that's how we do Lineangle notation.